Time for our Sunday morning Q&A. Joining us this morning is Howard County Executive Ken Ulman. Good morning.
Good morning. Thanks for having me.
Thank you for coming in. Well, we just had the new latest jobs report out for the nation. It was a bit underwhelming. How are things in Howard County?
Things are going well. I mean, we have the lowest unemployment rate in the state of Maryland. Again, we just got down to 4.8%. We were at 5.0. So we're making progress, but you know, we need the folks in Washington to get their act together. Sequestration is putting a real drag on the economy, and we're feeling that locally. We have over 50,000 Howard County residents who work either directly for the federal government or for federal government contractors, and so we are definitely starting to see the effect of the action.
How do you see that effect? How is it show itself in your county?
You know, we haven't seen it dramatically yet, but as people get furloughed, that means they have less money in their paycheck to support their families. They're paying less taxes. So we see it in our revenue streams as well, and we just don't know what the broad effect of that is. I have to introduce a budget in 2 weeks, and I don't know what the effect of the federal government's action is going to be.
Well, you just had some big program in Howard County, you know, for a lottery for homes. And it is a popular place for people to move. It's one of the best places for people to start families. But when you see these things, the sequester affecting your county, that's when people lose their homes and move out.
Well, it's very frustrating. You know, we can do our best job in Howard County, but we're tied to the state and we're tied to the federal government. Mm-hmm. So we have to keep that in mind, and it's a challenge.
All right, let's talk a little bit about the safety that you have efforts you've implemented in Howard County schools. Since
Sure.
I'm in the new town, we've seen different states trying to enact gun safety rules, but you're doing something in terms of your schools directly. Tell us about
it. Sure. We immediately pulled together our police chief, Bill McMahon, and our school superintendent, Renee Foos, and formed a task force to really look at school safety. And I didn't want it to be on a plan that was on a shelf for a year. I told them, you know, 90 days, and we're making some improvements right away. We've earmarked $2 million to make sure every school has a buzz-in system, is secure. We can also now get the feeds from the video cameras in a school directly in our 911 dispatch center. So some simple things that are important to make sure we're well coordinated. We also did a gun buyback just a couple weeks ago and had 631 guns that were turned in. And so a big piece of this is gun safety. You know,
right.
I know a child brought a gun to Glen Burnie High School last week. And you think, where are these folks getting the guns? Most likely they're in the house. And so, you know, gun ownership is clearly a right, but it's also a responsibility to have it secured and to maintain it well. And so we had a lot of people who brought them in and saying, you know what, I just don't want them in the house. I'm just not convinced I can keep them securely. So we were glad to get those off the street.
Are you gonna have another one?
We're looking at it now. Yeah, we were frankly overwhelmed by the response. We thought we'd get 100, maybe 200, and 631. So we probably will do another one.
All right. And you're one of the healthiest counties, the healthiest county in the state of Maryland. You just got that.
We are. The Robert Wood Johnson Foundation just came up with their study, and so we're really proud of the work we've done. We've got great people.
And you still do because of the insurance that Howard County offers.
Well, our Healthy Howard plan was a big impact because one of the things they look at is access to health care. Mm-hmm. And so we're really proud of that, but we still have work to do.
All right, you've got some serious work to do when it comes to your budget. What are you, with all of the different things that are not helping you when you have to come up with a budget, what are you going to focus on?
We focus on education and public safety. Those are the two that really drive the county, a safe county, and people come to Howard County for the school system. And so we're going to focus on those and then also focus on the environment and economic development and just the quality of life issues that make us such a great place to live.
What's going to fall by the wayside, you think?
You know, we're working through that process right now. We'll still be able to continue our focus.
All right, and you have some big medical research coming to Howard County?
We do. The American Cancer Society, every 20 years or so, does a big national study. They're looking for 150,000 people nationally to take part in a study. We're looking for 1,000 people in Howard County to take part in a study of the causes of cancer. So all you have to do is come to an event. We're announcing it on Tuesday night, but also agree to just give blood, fill out a form, but then be available for the next 20 years to give updates on your lifestyle. They want to know genetics, the environment, what causes cancer, so we can really get some better understanding.
Is it a volunteer thing?
It's all voluntary.
There's no extra money for
that. All voluntary.
All right, and before you go, are you going to be announcing that you're going to run for governor?
Well, you know, thank you for that flattering question. I'm glad that folks are interested in our future. I'm proud of the work we've done in Howard County. I am term limited, so You know, my wife says I need a job, and we're going to be taking a look at what's next very soon.
And did she say she needs a new house, too?
You know, she's a wonderful, wonderful partner and very encouraging.
All right. So that was a good way of going around that question. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
All right.
Thanks for having me.
Don't go away. We'll be right back with more news in a moment.